It's Saturday, the 29th in the evening, and as promised in last vlog, I would give a small update on the listings for eBay. It's a lot of work to backtrack which accessory, which minifigure had, but it's all a one-time time investment, as I now have the cards, and next time it should be easier if one sells. Almost done. I think I'm 75% done with the minifigures I have, so the last stretch is there, and then all the minifigures are on eBay. It's Sunday, the 30th of January, and I'm working on the last batch of minifigures. I'm gonna take some photos and then upload them. And then all minifigures currently are on eBay. Later today, the Ninjago set will be parted out. And I've got to do some organizing of the sticker sheets and some more things. So, enough to do. Let's get on with it. All caught up on eBay. 52 listings. Should be a decent sample size for now. If I get new minifigures, I will be adding them to eBay. But for now, I think this is enough to test it. And now on to rearranging the sticker sheets so that's done more efficiently. All the sticker sheets are done. This is binder S01. I labeled all the pages in the bottom right with a number, so it all counts up. And we've gotten three types of sheets. One is for business cards and smaller sticker pieces, like these. And then slightly bigger stickers, the photo size. And then the biggest pieces which don't fit in the other compartments, and they are all separated. And I skipped a page. Whoops. Well, that's how I arrange them. Really happy with it for now, as it's more efficient to do the small stickers like this as to in such a big sheet. So improved something again. Really happy with it. We've gotten three orders so far today. One still has to be paid, so I will pick that later. And two other orders. Going to use the multi-order picking sheet from Brick Freedom for the first time, as I don't know how to turn it off. So let's see if I can work with it and if it's something I like or if it's too sensitive for mistakes. So yeah, I'll get back to you after I'm done. Both of the orders are packed. This order, the customer messaged me if he could add some pieces. So I'm gonna see if they are still in stock and add them. And this order is done. I did like the possibility to pick multiple orders at one time, but it also takes a level of focus to make sure the right pieces go in the right box. So yeah, need some more practice with that, I suppose. One more thing, one of the packages I just packed is going to Switzerland, and I just recently opened up those countries, so it's great to see that after such a short period of time, it already
pays off to open the shipping to that country. For now, I'll be parting out the Hanes Power Up Mac Evo set. It consists of just 3 bags, pretty small ones, and the book. So, yeah, ready for the chopping block. Quite an easy part out, not that many lots. For the minifigures, 2 will be safe for eBay, 2 will go into the Bricklink store for now. If for some reason eBay takes off with the minifigures, I might consider focusing the minifigures on there. But for now, that's all speculation, so we'll see. First, let's put away these parts. All done. Collected the minifigures for eBay. They will go in the needs pictures pile. When I was uploading, I've gotten another order for a minifigure. So let's see if I can pick it with one hand. I can. Small order going to Austria. Today has definitely been one of the busiest days regarding orders. We are already at 4 in one day. One of them still needs to be paid, but I suppose that will get in later today or tomorrow morning. And then that order will be picked too and shipped. So good to see that the orders per day is picking up. As some of you said, I also can use a bubble mailer to ship smaller items, especially when they go to another European country. I usually use a box like this, but that's pretty overkill. So I'm going to send the bubble mailer as a small package and follow the advice some of you guys gave me. So thanks, and we'll see how it turns out. It's Monday, the 31st of January, and the last payment for the order also came through. So picked it before my day job, so we can ship it in my lunch break. Pretty crazy to think we've gotten 5 orders over the course of Sunday. Definitely the highest orders amount for a day. So really great to see, and thank you all for the orders. And another small bonus order picked. So I'm on my lunch break now, and now all the orders will get shipped. No more procrastinating. I'm going to start working through the used lot of black pieces, so we at least get some progress on that part. And yeah, work through the used backlog we built up. Let's see if we can find more winning pieces like those, or even other pieces with a high value. Maybe we're lucky, maybe we're not. Let's find out. Decided to pick out some pieces, as it makes the task a bit less daunting. Got some really unique pieces already. Some chariot wheels, some, I don't know, airplane stuff, I guess. And this one, at first I thought it was a Lego, but it says Lego right in there. This piece is quite unique, never seen it before. And of course those. So now I need to find them so I can upload them to Bricklink. Found another good piece, this train thing. And its 6 month sales average is 850. So that's
pretty steep, but it is an old part. It's in great condition, so yeah. Let's list it and see what happens.
As I was working on the used parts, we've gotten an order, so I pulled that to immediately fill up the freed up lots again. So we don't have empty spaces. For this piece, as it's so valuable, I bagged it to prevent more damage. And now we're going to upload them to BrickLink. It's Tuesday, the 1st of February. We've gotten two BrickLink orders. One is waiting for payment, so I can't ship that today, or the payment has to come in before 5 o'clock. The other one I picked and will be shipped the same day, as it's a bonus order and a pretty small one, so we can easily ship that today. More and more I'm realizing how addicting it is to run a BrickLink store, as you only want to grow and grow bigger. So that's a really good sign. I really enjoy doing this. And since the start of this store, I haven't been bored for a second. So yeah, it's pretty addicting. Really cool. Just picked up a used lot of Lego. It's mostly Chima related stuff. Got it very cheap. And I bought it for the minifigures. So let me unpack everything and let's see what's in it. It contains a, by the looks of it, complete Chai Mongus. And the other sets also seem to be complete, but I'll think those are getting parted out, as I mainly got this for the 8 minifigures. Really like the looks of them. Never had Chima before. It's something quite unique. But as far as I can tell and know, Chima wasn't the most popular team of Lego. So I'm not expecting crazy finds or anything like that. But yeah, these will go on eBay just to expand the selection over there, and we'll see how they will do in the end. It's Wednesday, the 2nd of February, and we've gotten one order to pull for BrickLink, as it was paid today, it came in yesterday. So always good to see they come through. One, 717, with all the lightsaber rails, and 1246, Nice and small order with one minifig of the Princess Leia. All ready to ship, as I don't have much time today. This will be the only thing I'll do, and tomorrow we got a load to do. Totally forgot this came in today. That doesn't matter. Three times. The Friends Treehouse. It's quite a big set. So this will wait until the weekend, but happy it came in today. Yeah, so then I don't have to wait anymore. Nice. It's Thursday, the 3rd of February.
And we've gotten two orders, one breakout order, some used pieces, and two new pieces. And a pretty big Bricklink order with some of the Eternal minifigures, minions, some city. Bought all the Star Wars guns I had listed, so that's great to see. Some tiles and some capes. The order also has a note. It says, "Good morning. It's about time I order from you. Keep it up with the YouTube channel and the store. Greetings from Vlissingen. P.S. You can send it in a bubble mailer." Which is becoming kind of a running joke, as I sent some small pieces in a big box, as I didn't know you can send a bubble mailer as a box. So yeah, thank you both for the order. Really appreciate it. And enjoy the pieces. First thing we are going to do tonight is break down the Chimungus and list that on Bricklink. Was thinking about listing it on eBay, but it's quite big and the shipping costs would make it very unappealing, I think. So yeah, let's break them down and see if it's complete. It's quite fun to reverse engineer a set like this. Also cool and unique pieces. Now let's see if it's complete. Without the spare parts, Chimungus is complete. The book is a bit folded, so I will put them between some heavy items, so it will straighten out a bit. But I've made a mention that it's with the original bag, but it has been cut open and with instructions which are folded a bit, as they are, so the buyer knows what he's buying. And I'm really curious to see how this will sell. I'm not starting with the friend set to part out on purpose, as I've learned from my previous part outs. On a weeknight, they tend to get quite late, so I'll save this for the weekend, as I have enough time to take the time. For now, I've decided to make the executive decision to pull all the video tiles from the wall and put them in this box slash tray, and we'll put them up there so they don't occupy spaces which can be used for faster moving parts. And I'd rather take the time a bit to take them out of the box, as to waste some space I really need for, yeah, parts. So let's start with that. And done. That definitely wasn't the most fun thing to do, but I think it will be beneficial to the store, as these won't move very quickly, and taking that time when I do sell them is better. Especially when you think we've gained quite a few lots which were occupied by video tiles, and now I can use them for different parts from the friend set. The main reason is the friend set will fill up quite a lot of the wall. Maybe, nah, not everything, but enough. And I still got some sets which should come in over the weekend. And then I suspect the wall will be full. And as I'm not planning on expanding yet, I had to do this so the parts which will sell will have the room against those
video tiles. When the wall is full, I'm not expanding again for now, as I need to get used to work on a rotation, sell enough to get enough free space so I can fill it up again. And I'm going to test run it with the space I have now to see how that goes and what needs to be done eventually to work like that in this small room. So yeah, that's why I did the not so fun video tiles job, but it's all done now.
We've gotten a small Brickall order. Lately, Brickall has been keeping up with how do you call it? Bricklink. So that's really good to see that the platform is gaining some traction. So we get some orders from Bricklink and Brickall, so that makes it worth to sync the stores and keep listing on both sides. It's not a huge order, but every order counts, so there we go. Thank you for the order. Was just talking about how Brickall is picking up, and now we've got an order for 65 lots and 384 items. So on to picking again. And the order is all done. It's quite a large order. Took me some time to pick it, but I really enjoy the picking part of the job, so gave me a lot of joy. So thank you for the order. Have fun with the pieces and keep them coming. It's Friday, the 4th of February. And we've gotten the first of the two packages I'm expecting in. This one contains 10 times the Ninjago Legacy set, Epic Battle set, Kai versus Skulkin, with some great minifigures. Bought 10 of them, so they will be parted out in the weekend. And we'll add some cool minifigures to the store. Done with the day job. Now the humongous task to part out this set. There's a book and a sticker sheet. And 8 bags with parts. 2 bigger parts. And I guess I need to empty the cups in between to get it all into the store. But that's okay. It will take me some time, but it will add around 200 new lots. So that's really great. Small update. We're making great progress. One more bag after this. And we're filling up the wall quite nicely. But it does take some time. It's a big part out. Had to take some Red Bull to stay focused, as it's been a long day after working first. But that's okay. Can't wait to see how far we fill up the wall when we're done. Put all the parts away. The minifigures and accessories, I'll look at them tomorrow, as it's getting quite late. And I'm just done for today. After uploading, we hit 45,000 parts and 3,500 lots, which will increase a bit after I dealt with minifigures. And we've added 184 new lots. So that's a great great number to add to the store. We filled the wall until drawer 1368. I did think it would get filled more, But we still have got a Ninjago set to do, and I just got a set in, so I'll show that now.
This is the city set that came in the mail today. So that gets on the Bardo backlog. And I'll finish this later this weekend with the minifigures from the Friends set and the Ninjago set. Don't know when, as I have a pretty busy weekend ahead. But we'll see if I can find the time. It's Saturday, the 5th of February. We've gotten two small orders overnight, one Bricklink, one Brick All. So I picked them. As I mentioned before, today I don't have a lot of time to spend on the Lego store, but we'll see how much we'll manage to squeeze in. As always, thank you for the orders and enjoy the pieces. Been to a few Goodwill stores today, no Lego action sadly. So I'm deciding to take the day off. These will be parted out next week or tomorrow. Then we'll fill up the wall with the rest of the used lot I've got. And we'll add minifigures to the eBay store again. So thank you all for watching. Have a nice week, and I'll see you in the next vlog. Bye bye.